It took me a while to put this list together, but finally I have it. This is the designer masterpieces list of fragrances that I think are really, really great and some of my favorites. And I would call them masterpieces the way they're created. But this video is done in a way that the fragrances here on this list are either male targeted or unisex. So if you want to find out what they are, and this is a ranked video, then please stay tuned. Thanks so much for tuning in. This is Sebastian, and yes, today I'm talking about designer masterpieces. And the way I've done this video is that they're either male targeted or unisex, and no feminine targeted releases here. And of course, some of the unisex fragrances, or the majority of the unisex fragrances, are from the designers' luxury collections or privates and exclusives and things like that. So anyway, I've got 20 of them. Plus, I've got bonuses. I've got many bonuses. And this is going to be a faster than normal video, as I'm not going to get into the detail of each of the fragrances too much. So I wanted to do a quick one. So either way, I'll let you know what they are before I do. If this is your first time tuning in and you still haven't subscribed, please click that subscribe button below and also click the bell so that you'll be notified for future videos and giveaways. So if you haven't caught my niche version of this video, which I did a month or so ago, you can go catch that. I'll have it linked in the info box. You can find it and click on it to watch that. But as I said, it took me a little longer to put this one together. I was wondering if I wanted to put together male, female, and unisex. But I left off the feminine fragrances. I will follow up and do a separate video if I can, because if I have enough. But, and we're going to start off with a number 20. And this is starting off with a unisex fragrance, even from a signature line. It's from the House of Hermes. This is Voyage d'Hermes here. I find this to be such a great release, especially in the parfum version, because this is the parfum version in the dark bottle. This is a tester, actually, that I have purchased. But it's such a great release, and it's actually really a great fragrance interpreting cardamom. If you like the smell of cardamom, if you've ever opened up a jar of cardamom and you've taken that whiff, this is that, basically, and then some. It's such a beautiful, spicy, aromatic fragrance that I love. It's authentic smelling, real smelling. And if you're into the idea of spices or wearing spices, I think this is perfect. So we're starting off the list with the Hermes Voyage d'Hermes Parfum at number 20. Heading off to Gucci for Gucci Guilty Absolute Pour Homme at number 19. This was a great release when it came out because, you know, I wasn't a big fan of Gucci for a long time. All throughout the 2000s, actually maybe mid-2000s on to probably when this launched, I hadn't even looked at a single Gucci fragrance up until when this came out. It felt like paying tribute to some of the early 2000s powerhouse fragrances, but in much more of a modern way. It utilizes lots of leather, so there's a bit of animalic touch in here. A lot of damp, humid kind of vetiver in here as well, but still very grassy and earthy, woody. So the combination is overly masculine, and I felt like it's a great scent. So it's ended up at number 19, but if you like the idea of that kind of like a powerhouse fragrance in modern you know, era release, definitely check this one out. It's at number 19 because I find some of the other ones a little more, and this is ranked in a way that I find the other fragrances on the list that come after this more of a masterpiece, but definitely a great release from this house. So this is Gucci Guilty Absolute Pour Homme at number 19. This next one is a unisex fragrance from the House of Maison Margiela. This is By the Fireplace. By the Fireplace is such a great fragrance featuring chestnuts and warm, spicy notes. You know, kind of like basically sitting by the fireplace and roasting some chestnuts. So there's a little bit of a nutty touch. There's smoky touches, but it's all very warm, spicy. It's a great scent, probably the best fragrance from this house. At least to me it is. And I quite like it and enjoy it. It smells really, really great. And I like the combination of the smokiness, the warm, ambery spiciness, and just a kind of a cozy experience with that smoke thrown in. Anyway, By the Fireplace at number 18. At number 17, going to the house of Hermes once again, and this is Equipage Geranium. This is such a great release from this house. It's almost like a fougere-like experience for the wearer or the person that wears this fragrance, because that geranium adds a kind of a rosy, minty, citricness to the fragrance that makes for a wonderful wearing experience. So there's a little bit of a barbershop-y touch in here. There's sandalwood in here as well, and just a beautiful combination. Rarely gets spoken about. Probably the one fragrance from Hermes for men that people talk about is Terre d'Hermes, but I've left it off the list, but you'll find out more about what I've featured in this video. But I think this is definitely a solid release if you're looking for kind of a woody, spicy, herbal aromatic kind of an experience. Try Equipage Geranium from the house of Hermes. At number 16, going to the house of Lalique, this is Encre Noir à la Extrême for a great, great smelling vetiver. Really does smell great, and I think it's great that this is more of a luxury take on the original Encre Noir. A little more deeper, a little more richer, there's some resins added to it, but it's mostly about vetiver with cypress. And then people say there's a little bit of an oudi touch. I don't get that for myself, but I just find it to be a very, very classy, luxurious take on the original Encre Noir that's really great to wear. It's from a designer, you can get it for really inexpensive, and I think Nathalie Lorson, who did this, took the original, made a much, much nicer version of that original Encre Noir, which kind of to me is a little bit on the minimalistic side, not so complex. Here, definitely it's a lot more complex version. So at number 16, Encre Noir à la Extrême for a great, great fragrance. All right, at number 15, going to the house of Guerlain and its Heritage. And I've featured Guerlain here on this list because I find them to be more like a designer kind of a brand rather than a niche, because they've been around since the 1800s. But this Heritage, even though it came out in the early 1990s, I find it to be very, very modern. I believe it's been given the reformulation, and I think the reformulation for this is really great. And it's kind of like a woody, spicy, bordering fougere kind of a release that's really, really to die for, and I think still smells great to this day. It does feature patchouli, it does feature lavender, it does feature oak moss, and of course sandalwood for a great smelling fragrance. Very classic, a little old school, but definitely a solid release. So this is Guerlain's Heritage at number 15. Such a great fragrance to wear. The next fragrance I'm talking about, if I can find it, is here. It is from the house of Cartier. This is Pacha de Cartier Parfum, this one right here. I can never see the name on there. It's so bright. So light, actually, I should say. This one, to me, is such a great release from this house. They kind of, you know, brought back something that was from the early 90s, just like Heritage. Kind of in that similar ballpark as well. Patchouli, woods, and, you know, kind of barbershop-y kind of fougere-like fragrance. And then they modernized it, adding warm and kind of ambery touches in here. So they've added sandalwood. They've also added some synthetic molecules like ambroxan, but they've added some boozy touches. And of course, there's some pine in here. And of course, typical kind of like herbal notes to create kind of like a warm, spicy fougere barbershop fragrance. Really, really great. Check that out if you don't know it. This is Cartier's Pacha de Cartier Parfum. Next fragrance I'm talking about is a classic fragrance that I definitely need to have on here. It's probably one of the best citruses for men, and it still smells wonderful today. This is at number 13. It's a Dior Eau Sauvage. Eau Sauvage is so great, guys. Really, really great smelling fragrance. I know it's light, but I think it still, you know, reminds me of what Eau Sauvage used to be. And it's a great, a fresh, aromatic, spicy, citrusy take on, you know, a fresh fragrance, a men's masculine fragrance that's really wonderful. There's some light vetiver in here. There's lots of aromatics and herbs and lots of citruses, green citruses and herbs. Green herbs and other, you know, like aromatic herbs combined with that vetiver and citruses to create one fresh, aromatic, spicy, citrusy fragrance. So that's at number 13, Dior Eau Sauvage, a wonderful fragrance. This next fragrance is from the house of Tom Ford. This is Ombre Leather. I think this is a great leather fragrance. Wonderful release. This is a unisex targeted. I'm putting it in this list because as I said, I'm doing a male or unisex fragrances. And you know, if you can get this and completely like dismiss a Tuscan leather, I think it's totally fine, because the two fragrances do remind me of one another, but I find that this one's a little more wearable than Tuscan leather. Tuscan leather is a little more, I wouldn't call it challenging, but just not like It's not as like embraceable, like it's not like really easily, but it's still a great fragrance. But this one to me has kind of lots of leather with a little bit of a fabric material, like a kind of a smell combined with it. There's some light fruity touches and ambery touches and a few other notes to create the wonderful leather fragrance wearing experience. It's a dark fragrance, but a wonderfully created release that I think definitely deserves to be on this list. So this is number 12. This is Ombre Leather from the House of Tom Ford. Then moving on to Costume Nationale at number 11, it's Costume Nationale Homme, or you can go with the Homme Parfum. I prefer the Parfum because I do have it. They're very close though. I just find this one to be a little more concentrated, but a great take on a wonderful fragrance. It's fruits and amber and patchouli and sandalwood, but a beautiful, beautiful wearing experience. I like the heft about it, and it reminds me of autumn with its fruitiness and its ambery touches, and of course the woods and patchouli in here make for a wonderful wearing experience. It smells really, really great, and I wanted to definitely feature one fragrance from this house because it's so underrated, and I went with Costume Nationale Homme because this is a male or unisex video. So this is great. Check it out. If you can't get the Parfum, I think the original is totally fine, and the Eau de Parfum concentration really solid release from this house. So this is Costume Nationale Homme Parfum Edition. Next fragrance, going to the House of Chanel. This is Coromandel. Had to have this one here. Had to have a great patchouli fragrance, and this one definitely deserves the spot at number 10 in the top 10. And I think this is a great release with lots of patchouli, woods, and some resins to create a kind of a white chocolatey, creamy kind of a consistency. But the patchouli is king here. That's what I love about it. It's very, very sexy, it's sparkly, and you've got some light woods under there as well to create for one luxurious, lightly gourmandish take on patchouli. So this is Chanel Coromandel at number 10. Next, going to the House of Dior once again. This is Eau Sauvage Parfum. I do prefer this one a little more than the original, and I wanted to separate these fragrances from the original to the Parfum because they're so different. I mean, even though it's the similar DNA, they do have a different wearing experience. This one's a lot more resinous, a lot more deeper, a lot more richer, and I do prefer it over something like a Freshie, and just love that whole concentrated Eau Sauvage experience here in the Parfum version. Yes, this is the 2017 version. The 2012 version was a lot deeper and richer, but if this is all we can get, this is all we can get. And I love this because of the resins, the vetiver, the citruses, just a deeper, richer experience. And I think it's a solid release from this house. So this is number 9, Dior Eau Sauvage Parfum. Next up, going to the House of Tom Ford once again. This is Noir de Noir. This to me is one of the first fragrances I bought from this house, probably the first private blend. It's an absolutely amazing and orgasmic kind of a smell with the kind of dark rose, patchouli, oak moss. There's the truffles that are in here, the truffles that grow underground. So there's earthiness about this. It's considered a chypre, and I absolutely love it. It's very, very sexy to wear. It has a great trail and things like that. Although I think it's gotten a little lighter since when I first started wearing it in the early 2010s, but still the smell is fantastic, and I think definitely deserves to be here on this list. So Noir de Noir at number 8, and it's from the House of Tom Ford. Next up, going to the House of Dior once again, this is Fahrenheit Le Parfum. Such a great release. They did such a wonderful job, or Francois Demache did such a wonderful job with this version, bringing it to the modern age, making it a lot more unisex, even though it's male targeted. I think this is great because they've taken that violet leaf note, the violet or violet leaf note in here, gives us this ozonic touch. Combine it with leather, vanilla, with a booziness in here for a really wonderfully cozy wearing experience. Very, very delicious. Definitely notice the violet leaves in here, as I said. That is definitely the leather. But it doesn't have that gasoline kind of a note that's in the original, although it's no longer in the Eau de Toilette. I don't pick it up much. It's been reformulated enough. That one's not made it on this list. This one definitely has. And it's a great, great fragrance. It smells wonderful. This is at number 7. This next one, I talk about it a lot. I think it's one of the best fragrances from a designer, and I absolutely love the way it smells. This is from Bentley. This is for Men Intense at number 6. Oh boy, this is so good. It's dark, it's woody, it's spicy, it's ambery, it's resinous, it's a little smoky, there's a little patchouli. A fantastic wearing experience. It has a great dry down, really, really great sillage as well. And I absolutely think it's one of the best men's fragrances in the designer world. But you know what? I think women can totally pull this one off. For me, it kind of reminds me of two niche fragrances, Lubin's Idole and Chambre Noir from Olfactive Studio. If you know those two fragrances, kind of like taking those and kind of combining it to make its own unique fragrance. At least that's what it reminds me of for me. But it's such a great release. It deserves to be on this list at number 6 because I love wearing it. It's absolutely a delight to wear that one. The next fragrance at number 5, going to the house of Guerlain, Bois Mysteria. I'm featuring Guerlain, as I said, in this list. But boy, this is so good. It used to be in a different collection of fragrances. They moved it over to this collection, which makes sense. I like these bottles a lot. But this to me is very, very spicy, woody, leathery, aromatic with green kind of laurel, bay laurel note. And then there is that kind of patchouli in here, that very, very earthy, sweaty kind of smelling, lightly patchouli in here for a very, very sexy experience. Such a beautiful fragrance. It's to die for, actually. I think this is definitely deserving of the number 5 spot. This is Guerlain's Bois Mysteria. I love it. And those of you that know that fragrance, do you enjoy it? Or do you think it's a little too stinky for you or too sweaty smelling? All right, at number 4, going back to the house of Tom Ford, this is Tobacco Vanille. Definitely deserves to be here. As I said, there's either unisex fragrances here, a lot of unisex and or male targeted. And that one, to me, is a great interpretation of vanilla with lots of spices and tobacco, of course. The tobacco in that fragrance is definitely ashy. There's lots of spices in there. There's some fruits, a little cacao for one wonderful wearing experience. And it reminds me of the holidays. It's warm, spicy, more on the dry side, and just a pleasure to wear. I absolutely love that one. So number 4, Tobacco Vanille. And number 3, it's Fève Délicieuse from the house of Dior once again. This to me is such a beautiful take on a tonka bean fragrance. But the more I wear it, I've been mentioning recently, it reminds me a little bit of something like Naxos, which is kind of like almost going to that kind of a amber fougere direction. There's a little bit of lavender in here. But this definitely more of a gourmand take on tonka beans. It features fruits and caramel and vanilla and some chocolate. But the center stage is the tonka bean. The delicious bean is what it basically means. And it's really a delicious wearing experience. There's powdery touches. There's a little bit of a syrupy touch. But definitely deserves a number 3 spot here. Fève Délicieuse at number 3 for one delicious wearing experience. Number 2, I'm going back to the Chanel house. It's Le Lion. This is absolutely a delight to wear. It's that kind of a fragrance that kind of is reminiscent of several other fragrances. For me, it really hints at Shalimar, but then that disappears. It also hints at a few other fragrances. It also hints at their own fragrance, Coromandel, a little bit, but it's definitely warm, spicy, resinous, amber fragrance with light smoky touches, animalic touches. Yes, it kind of also hints at lightly at something like Cœur de Russie for the leather. There's a little bit of a leathery touch in here, but it's actually really, really great, created wonderfully, and you know, named after this very ferocious animal, and that's kind of fragrance this is. So great. One other thing I should say, there is a lemony touch up top when you first spray it that's definitely noticeable. So that's Le Lion at number 2. Can you guess my number 1? You probably already know. My number 1 is Dior Homme Parfum. This is probably my number 1 fragrance in any fragrance that I have. It's just that great of a fragrance. Taking that original Dior Homme into making into something like this, it's to die for. It's a wonderful, wonderful wearing experience and very, very tough to get, sadly. It's there. It's out there. You can get it. This, to me, is taking lots of iris with leather, a little bit of rose, a little bit of dark woods, and maybe some oud in here, and basically putting it together to create this very concentrated fusion of leather lipstick kind of a combo. Just imagine if you were a little kid and you kind of opened up your mom's purse, very, very, you know, fragrant leather purse, and you kind of like found the lipstick and you smeared it all over the leather. So you're kind of smelling this lipstick makeup kind of a combo with leather. That's what it is. It's very sexy fragrance. Really, really wonderful. I absolutely love it. Very, very concentrated in the Parfum version. So my number one is Dior Homme Parfum. And that's the list. You know, there's a lot of brands missing off of here. I just don't find them to be masterpieces. Mugler is completely off. I don't know what's going on with that brand. Sorry. It's their loss, not mine. But these are definitely the fragrances I'm feeling for this list, and I think they're definitely masterpieces and ones that I speak about a lot over and over and over and over again. Anyway, let me know your thoughts on these fragrances and which fragrances. Give me a top five of your masterpiece designer fragrances. Could be male targeted, could be unisex, could be feminine. I'd like to find out. Put a comment down. Either way, guys, thanks so much for watching today's video. If you have any questions or comments, please list below. Please like this video. Please share it. Follow me on Facebook and Instagram, and I'll be back with more videos very soon. Have a good one. Goodbye. Real quickly, I wanted to mention six more fragrances that I think should be on this list, but obviously I can't add them to a top 20. So these are the honorable mentions or bonuses. We've got Cartier's Declaration Parfum. It's a great release. It's taking the original Cartier Declaration into more of a concentrated, sexier take on that fragrance with spices, woods, and leather. Tom Ford's Oud Wood should have been on this list, but you know, I couldn't fit it on here. I think it's a great fragrance, very, very classy, spicy, oudy. Deserves a mention at least. Caron, I'm adding Caron on this list, and Pour Un Homme de Caron, such a classic fragrance. It's definitely a masterpiece. And even though it's been around since, almost 100 years, I think it still smells great. It's a lot lighter than it used to be, but definitely a solid release that's male targeted, but totally unisex. This is Caron, Pour Un Homme de Caron I'm talking about. Louis Vuitton's Ombre Nomade, another great fragrance that didn't make the list, but definitely worthy of a mention. I think they did a great job with that oud. Lightly rosy, but very resinous and leathery take on oud from a designer. Hermès Terre d'Hermès Parfum. It's an honorable mention. I think it deserves the attention, but didn't make my top 20. But very, very popular, very successful fragrance for Hermès, focusing on citruses with a vetiver. And then finally, the latest release from Dior Privé, Dior's Vanilla Diorama. It's so good. It's the more I wear it, the more I love it. And it's a great vanilla fragrance. So beautiful. Citrusy, chocolatey, powdery, gooey, deliciousness. Anyway, those are the last of the fragrances I'm talking about. Didn't make the top 20, but definitely great honorable mentions. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you have a wonderful Saturday. Goodbye.